More than 400 years ago, Mughal Empress Nur Jahan brought a delicate hand embroidery from Central Asia to India. It took firm roots in Lucknow and its surrounding areas and came to be known as Lucknow Chikankari. Mostly worked by women at home during their spare time, it was a skill passed on from mother to daughter or mother-in-law to daughter-in-law.
समझानो कि बेटी ऐसा है कि काम जो कर लेओ तो कोई दिन तुम खाना बनाए लेओ रोटी दाल जो बनाओ बनाए लेओ और ठीक है छाही में बढ़िया बैठे हो और बढ़िया धीरे-धीरे कर रहे हो काम तो कहीं कि अरे ना ही परेशान हो जा तुम इन परेशान नहीं हुए चार पैसा है आदमी से नहीं कहते सो डालो साबुन लाओ
While chikankari enjoyed the patronage of the Nawab of Oudh, it fell into disarray soon after, leading to a fall in the quality of work, low wages for the artisans and a distorted market structure.
The fact is that the end product cost is not completely 100% artisan ko nahi pass on hota, wo ho bhi nahi sakta because cost add hote, because processes add hote. Lekin ek jo ek healthy distribution hai, wo zarur hona chahiye.
The artisans who occupied the lowest rung of this ecosystem came to hold the least bargaining power.
They should get the benefit of the real price, right? So I think this is the, you know, this is the chance and that I'm playing on, that this bit we have to invest to make them a fine artist.
Hi, I'm Shalini. I'm here on Wishberry to raise funds for my film Thread of Life. This is my second independent film, and the first was a fiction short called Watch the Stars for Me Tonight, which won an award for best direction. When I went to Lucknow last year, I was introduced to a local craft called chikankari. Soon I was interested to make a film about its revival and recognition. Thanks to the efforts of an NGO, this was also awarded the geographical indicator. Over a period of time, I met three women whose lives were deeply linked with chikankari one way or the other. They had really got out of their comfort zones and they were pushing the boundary of this chikankari. Finally, this film became about them in the backdrop of the story of chikankari. Until now, I have completed 75% of this production. To start with, I used my personal savings and crowdfunded the rest of the production. Later, we received a grant from the Indian National Trust for Art and Cultural Heritage. In fact, Thread of Life is going to be a part of their knowledge series too. To complete this, I need to raise another 80,000 rupees. This is for post-production, which will be used towards script, voiceover, narration and editing, as well as sound design. And that's why I'm crowdfunding with Wishberry. This is an all or nothing campaign and I have only 30 days to raise this amount. This means that if we don't hit the target in 30 days, all the money goes back to the backers. If you help me fund this film, you're funding a film which already has an audience. Apart from traveling to heritage film festivals, this will also be available on the Times Internet, which is a new online channel of the Times Group. I request all of you to contribute to complete this film. I want everyone to get to know about this art form because it's not just about heritage, but it's also about women's empowerment. So do help complete it.